Hello everyone, in this video I am going to show you how to configure the forms with the Bootstrap provided classes. Means how to beautify forms by using the Bootstrap provided classes. Okay, let's start. I am opening my VS Code editor and I am opening the forms example basic layout. So right now this is a common forms, but it doesn't look nice. So how you are going to beautify this one? Very simple class we have in our Bootstrap. So right now observe, we have for every input control, what is the class I am applying? Form control. As well as in the Bootstrap, every input control should have a label. That is why I am applying one special class label. So this is the configuration we need to do. So for the input form-control, for the corresponding label form-label. So I saved this one. I am reloading the web page now. How beautiful it is. Now with the simple configuration without any CSS knowledge, we are able to create what's a very beautiful UI. So this is the way I am going to configure WhatsApp, our application, very good UI pages. So let me configure one more thing, form-label for the input form-control. Sometimes we need to display some helpful text. So very simple, form-text. So let me refresh. See how beautiful it is. So this is the way I can configure in my application. So sir, this text field little bit width is high. So can I have a small text field? Yes, it is possible. So let me show you form-label. form-control-sm. So let me refresh. The company text field should look small. form-control. See sir, the width little bit decreased comparatively these two. In the same way, I have the LG option is also available, means larger area. Now you can see little bit long width wise it is having the things. So this is the way I can configure not only the input classes, other areas also. Before that there are predefined. Suppose if it is a disabled look, it will look in this way sir. If it is a read only also, you cannot enter the data at the time we are having disabled look. Next one, sir, I have a checkbox, how to style this one? So let's see. So form-check input, little bit change sir. In the same way, form-check label. So these are the classes I am applying. Let's see the beauty. So see, my checkbox is beautified or not. So this is the way I am going to configure. For the radio buttons also, the classes are same, form-check-input as well as form-check-label. So this is the way I can configure in our application radio buttons as well as the checkbox. So you can see how beautiful it is. Yes, it is definitely beautiful when we are comparing with normal HTML provided or browser default one. So this is a way I can style radio buttons as well as the checkboxes. In the same way, in the project or in any web page, we can have what's a select, means like the country list is there or the state list are there. At that time, how you are going to style this one? very simple, form hyphen select. And in the same way, sorry, this is the label, that is why we are going to configure the label first. Later on I am going to configure form hyphen select. So let us see. So this is the normal drop down. This is a Bootstrap related style drop down. So this is the way I can do the things in our program. Sir, how you are going to configure the multi select box? So very simple, observe, form hyphen label, and in the same way, what is a class, sir? Form hyphen select. So the class is, so see, so this is the drop down with multi select option. So this is the way I can style my drop down or select box. Sir, okay, I understand. Sir, how to style the text area? Very simple, the same way, sir. There is no different in the class, form hyphen label, and the same way here, form hyphen control. See how beautiful it is. So this is the way I am going to configure my text area. Sir, okay, I understand about all this one. How can I do with the input? So let me configure form hyphen label and form hyphen control. See, sir, how beautiful it is. So this is the one with the single select file, sir. Suppose sometimes we need to select multiple files, at the time we are going to use a, for the same input type equal to file, we are going to use a multiple attribute. So how you are going to style this one? Very simple, form hyphen label, and the same way, the same class, sir, for any text field, most of the text fields or most of the input fields, sir, form hyphen control. So let me refresh. Now you can see there is a slight variation is there. This one, no file is selected, it is a multi-select one, that is why no file selected. So this is the way I am going to configure the class for the input field, form hyphen label. Now I want to style the range. Sometimes in our application we need to display some range related ones, are like price or the loan years. So likewise we are going to have, so at that time we can use a range related one. At that time we can use this one. See how beautiful it is, beautifully laid out. So this is the way I am going to configure. What is the class for this one, sir? Form hyphen range. So these are the things, are basic styling options available in the Bootstrap to for the form related things, sir. There are other options also there. Let us see. Sir, I have a checkbox, but I want to display as a switch. So how it is possible? Form hyphen observe switch. So let me refresh our UI. Now you can see your checkbox is displaying it as a switch. It is totally possible. And in the same way, sir, I want to display the checkbox in line, means side by side. How it is possible? Form hyphen check hyphen inline. I have two checkboxes. These two checkboxes I want to display inline. See, in the same line we have the checkbox. It is totally possible. So this is about the inline checkboxes. Next one is a very interesting option. So you have seen this kind of thing in the latest websites. So this one I would call it as a input group. This one I would call it as a input group. Sir, I want to display at the rate beside the text field. That is my requirement. So very simple, how you are going to do this one? Very simple, we are going to call it as input groups. Now observe, This one I would call it as input group text. So I want to display some text content beside the input. See how beautiful it is. So this is the way I'm going to configure my input groups. So let me show you the configuration once. What is the class I'm going to configure? Input group and as well as the input group text. Now, sir, I understand all these things. In any project, we are going to have validations. Without validation, there is no project. Sir, you can ask me like, sir, what are the validation related classes Bootstrap is provided? So let me show you. I want to display what is the class is valid. Valid feedback. So let me show you. See, sir, how beautiful it is. So right now it is displaying some green color because it is a success and check more, it is good, as well as I am providing the feedback. So sometimes we need to display invalid also. At the time, what is the class I need to apply? Is invalid. And in the same way, we need to create a div with what options are invalid feedback. Let me refresh. So see, sir, the visual clues are the highlight in the Bootstrap. Any user can easily understand the UI. That is the beauty of the Bootstrap. So in order to create this beautiful UI, you no need to have any CSS master knowledge, sir. Basic knowledge is sufficient, but with basic knowledge also you are able to create a very, very beautiful application. That is why Bootstrap is a preferable choice for any company. Thank you.